Welcome back to the channel and hello if you are new here. I'm Colin and in today's video, we have an exciting comparison lined up. I'll be looking at two similarly priced flagship dongle decks, the iBasso DC Elite and the iFi Go Bar Kensei. We'll explore their features, form factor, build quality, user experience, and sound performance. Before diving into this review, I want to highlight that at this price point, the law of diminishing marginal returns becomes quite evident. With dongle decks performing so well these days, you might only see a 5-10% improvement in sound quality, even if you're paying significantly more than what you're currently using. Whether that extra investment is worth it ultimately depends on your preferences and what you're seeking. Now, enough talk, let's see what these flagship decks come with. I'm not going to go into the unboxing process in this video as I don't want the video to be too long. Here's what both dongles come with. They both include a lightning cable, a Type-C cable, a USB-A adapter, or a leather pouch or sleeve. The iFi comes in a special etched bamboo box and the iBasso has pretty normal packaging. The DC Elite is iBasso's ambition to create the best dongle deck available. To achieve that, the DC Elite uses a flagship deck chip BD34301EV by ROM and a 24-position, 4-section stepped attenuator, similar to what's used in iBasso's $3,500 flagship deck, the DX320 Max. The stepped attenuator is designed to solve the issue of bit reduction that will occur in digital volume controls and maintain a channel balance to under 0.1 decibels. iFi has a completely different approach in creating their flagship dongle. By working with JVC Kenwood for 18 months, iFi was able to bring JVC Kenwood's K2HD technology into Kensei. This technology was originally developed to restore the high-frequency data and details lost in 16-bit 44.1 kHz recordings, and made recording sound as close to the master recordings as possible. If you're interested in this technology, I have linked a video below regarding the development of K2HD. Other than K2HD, the Kensei used a Circus Logic DAC chip, but iFi doesn't specify which one. iFi also indicated that the use of high-quality capacitors and components for the Kensei that should reduce distortion level, noise level, and achieving better efficiency and stability. And of course, we have iFi's renowned X-Base and X-Base digital signal processing that's available in all iFi products. The two decks have a very different form factor. On the left, we have the DC Elite, and on the right, there's the Kensei. The DC Elite has a larger footprint compared to the Kensei, but weight-wise, they're actually pretty similar. The DC Elite is made from a titanium alloy shell with two tempered glass panels on top and bottom. The housing and the knob is really nice made. All the edges are really crisp and sharp. On the other hand, the Kensei has an enclosure made from Japanese stainless steel, which feels super heavy and solid. The surface has a brushed finish on it. Even the buttons on the side are made from metal and are nicely polished. Having tested both of the dongles using each of them exclusively for around a week, it is apparent that both of them have amazing sound quality, but their sound signature is actually quite different. I mainly tested them on my Orivedi Lowmaster that I reviewed last week, but I also tried them with other full-size headphones and IEMs. The DC Elite has a relatively neutral timbre. The background is black, pitch black, and it sounds very dynamic. The decay of the notes is quicker than the Kensei by comparison, and the bass hits harder and faster. On the other hand, the Kensei has a slightly warm timbre and has a forwardness in the presentation of the mids. The decay is lower and you hear the transients for a bit longer. The bass hits deep. Although not as impactful as the DC Elite, it has a slower attack when compared. The presentation of the highs are generally pretty similar between the two. I can't really point out the differences between them. The transients of the Kensei seem slightly longer in the highs. Regarding the imaging and presentation, the instruments and vocals of the Kensei sound very close and has a great sense of the music surrounding you. Everything sounds close and engaging. The DC Elite has a larger stage and everything seems to be pushed further than the Kensei. Music is not as engaging as the Kensei, especially if you're listening to pop, but the trade-off for that is a wider soundstage and impressive imaging. I don't think it is an exaggeration to say that the DC Elite has pinpoint imaging abilities when paired with the right IEMs. The staging and imaging technicalities create a holographic experience with live and classical recordings. On the other hand, the Kensei has a more immersive and engaging presentation, which works well with pop music. Not only that, but you also have the ability to turn on X space to create an illusion of a wider stage. There are a lot of things you can set with the Kensei. It's probably the most set I've ever seen in a dongle deck. The best part is that whatever setting you make, it will be displayed by the lights on the backside. By single pressing the function button here, you can toggle X space and X space. You can have either one on or both on. Long press the function button for a few seconds, and you'll be able to switch the digital filter settings using the volume down button, and toggle K2HD on or off using the volume up button. These four different colored LED lights represent different digital filters. You can refer to iFi's video for more details, I've linked it below. And there's a super useful feature on the Kensei, volume sync. By default, the Kensei has an independent volume control, but when you hold the function button for 8 seconds, it can sync the master volume to the volume of the device. It's super convenient when you're using the Kensei on the go and not having to deal with two volume controls. You can just adjust the volume of the Kensei using the volume buttons on your device. The DC Elite is a much more simpler device in terms of settings when compared. Without the Android app, there are basically no settings you can adjust other than the volume control and toggle coaxial output. Other than the volume knob, this side button here allows you to fine-tune the volume reduction by 3 decibels. You can toggle between 4 micro adjustment steps to adjust the volume. With the app, you can choose from 2 digital filters and channel balance adjustment. Unless you play DST files, there's really only the digital filters you may need to adjust from the app. Let me talk about my experiences with the Kensei. I really like the convenience of the Kensei being able to adjust so many settings with just a few presses. The display lights on the back are super smart. The sample rate lights will turn into a volume display when you adjust the volume, which is really useful. You can also go to synced volume control if you don't like reaching for the deck when you're on the go. However, there are some drawbacks when using the Kensei. First, there's a background noise when using sensitive IEMs with the IEM match off. So I always keep the IEM match feature on as the hiss is pretty noticeable. I haven't heard any deck that hisses as loud as the Kensei. It's pretty annoying and strange since decks nowadays are pretty much silent. Second, what's worse is that turning on the X space and K2HD filters will amplify the hiss even more. The hiss is noticeable when the K2HD filter is on, even with IEM match on. So I ended up not using these filters at all when paired with IEMs. One more thing that's worth mentioning is that there will be a pop sound in your headphones when you unplug the Kensei. So remember to unplug your headphones first before you unplug the Kensei from your device. Now I would like to share my thoughts on the K2HD filter. I think it does make a difference when listening to lossy or CD quality files. I hear a slight extension in the highs and it adds a bit of airiness to the sound, but it also adds more floor noise to what you're hearing. If you mainly stream lossy files when you're listening to music or have lots of 16-bit files, this might be a feature that's worth trying for you. But personally, I prefer having K2HD off. According to my research, what it's really supposed to do is restore the frequencies beyond 20 kHz. In other words, it's adding artifacts that weren't in the source file, and whether the effects beyond 20 kHz are audible is debatable too. But that doesn't subtract from the fact that the Kensei is a feature-rich and great-sounding deck. It's just that I prefer listening with the digital processing off, maybe sometimes with XBase on for more oomph. The DC Elite is a DAC that embodies a no-frills approach to audio. Rather than including various audio enhancing features, it focuses on delivering the best sound quality in a compact dongle form factor. During my time of use, I noted a few drawbacks. First, while its weight is comparable to that of the Kensei, the DC Elite is noticeably larger due to the inclusion of a stepped attenuator. Second, the volume pot presents some challenges compared to conventional volume buttons. It's somewhat difficult to adjust with one hand, and the control lacks the precision of digital volume controls, making it tricky to use on the go. There is also some distortion between steps when adjusting the volume, but this doesn't bother me since it only occurs during adjustments. At home or in a desktop setup, I have no issues with the volume control. In fact, I prefer it over digital controls because it provides a satisfying tactile feel. It feels similar to using a high-end desktop amplifier, except it's much smaller. Both dongles just get slightly warm while operating. Surface temps won't be an issue for either of the dongles. Regarding the current draw reading from my test rig, they also draw a similar amount of current from the power bank, with the DC Elite having a real-time draw of about 130 milliamps, and the Kensei also at around 130 milliamps. Both of these dongles cannot be referred as efficient, but considering their performance levels, I think it's acceptable. If you are not looking for a top-performing dongle, there are definitely more efficient options available. Out of the two dongles, the Kensei is the one with a higher rated power output. It's able to output 477 milliwatts at 32 ohms at the balanced port and 300 milliwatts at the single-ended port. On the other hand, the DC Elite only has a rated power output of 280 milliwatts at 32 ohms balanced and 162 milliwatts single-ended. Both of the dongles can easily drive any IEMs you pair with it. Pairing them with my Beyer Dynamic T1 3rd Gen, both of them can drive the T1 at relatively low volume levels with lots of headroom left even at the single-ended port. Although the T1 has a low impedance of 32 ohms, it has a high current demand which can be challenging for headphone amps. It is really designed to be used with a desktop amp instead of portable amps. I feel like the Kensei does slightly better in powering the T1 to fuller potential. Another thing to take note of is that the Kensei has a higher output voltage than normal dongle DACs at 7.2 volts balanced. Usually dongles have around 4 volts of power output balanced. This implies that the Kensei has a higher potential to drive high impedance headphones to higher maximum volume. At this stage, you probably just want me to tell you which one I prefer. Personally, I prefer the DC Elite due to its sonic performance. So let's put it this way. All the features aside, the Kensei has a much more intimate presentation. It sounds like the singer is singing right in front of you and instruments are close and surrounding you in a circular space. Some will refer to this kind of vocal presentation as much more soulful and with more emotions. Many will prefer this type of sound signature for pop and rock. Listening to the same track on the DC Elite, the singer sounds like he or she is about 3 to 4 feet away from you. Instruments don't feel like they are surrounding you as much, but you will feel like you can hear where they are placed in the room and where the sound is coming from. This is referred to as a deeper and wider soundstage. Most people prefer this kind of presentation for classical and more instrumental tracks. I believe the most significant difference in sound quality between the Kensei and DC Elite lies in their soundstage presentation. I hope this insight helps choose the right DAC for your needs. The reason I prefer the DC Elite is because I've never heard a dongle DAC capable of presenting a soundstage that's so wide and deep. So it really appealed to me when I first listened to it. It reminded me the sound of desktop DAC amp combos that cost multiple times more than the DC Elite. Ultimately, your choice should reflect your preferences and listening habits. But for me, the DC Elite stands out in the crowded market of DACs. Both dongle DACs offer excellent sound quality and shine in their own unique ways. The Kensei boasts a multitude of features allowing you to experiment with different headphones for music, movies, and more. If you enjoy tweaking settings and setups and require maximum power output in your dongle to drive full-size headphones, this DAC is definitely for you. In contrast, the DC Elite is much simpler, it's essentially a plug-and-play device, and I consider it to be the most impressive dongle deck I've encountered to date, particularly regarding its soundstage presentation and imaging capabilities. Is there a night and day difference compared to more budget options? Not exactly, but the improvement is certainly quite significant. In the world of decks, it can sometimes be very difficult to hear a discernible improvement, but I can hear that with my experience with the DC Elite. In terms of pure sound quality, the DC Elite is definitely one of the best, if not the best, competing with DAPs costing more than its asking price. It's definitely worth considering, especially if you're not planning to power any hard-to-drive headphones with it. At this point, you might wonder whether it's worth spending over $400 on a dongle deck. Honestly, only you can answer that question, as it really depends on your individual situation. If you're just starting out in the hobby, upgrading your IEMs and headphones will likely provide a greater wow factor than a deck upgrade. However, if you're more seasoned and have already settled on a few favorite sets, then investing in a high-quality deck like these could be well worth it for you. And this is the end of my review. Hope you liked it and found it useful. And please subscribe to the channel if you enjoy watching videos like these.